reverse osmosis is kind of a technical name put on something that's actually fairly simple. And that is, osmosis is when you have a membrane between a solution that has a lot of solvent in it, such as salt or sugar or something like that, and then the other side of the membrane has pure water. And what happens in that case is the water will cross the membrane to join the side that has something in solution. When we use reverse osmosis, we put that side with sugar on it under pressure, sometimes a fair amount of pressure, and that'll actually push water out of the solution through the membrane to the side that has no sugar. Well, the science behind it is what you have in a membrane is what we would call maybe a sheet polymer, and that polymer is chemically linked in such a way that it creates holes that are a very specific size, and they can make these polymers so that the holes are a big variety of sizes. So when we're talking about maple syrup, in that case, the holes in the polymer are the right size so that water passes through but sugar cannot. So when we put the sap under pressure against this sheet polymer that's part of that's the membrane, water will pass through the membrane and leave the sap, and the sugar then gets concentrated as it goes through the reverse osmosis membrane. The big advantage with reverse osmosis is that it takes almost no energy to remove that water. Whereas when you boil to remove the water, it takes about 10,000 BTUs per gallon of water removed. So instead of boiling for 8 to 10 hours on a run for a backyarder, now he only has to boil for an hour to maybe 2 hours at the most to get the same amount of syrup. That makes it fun in my book, not grueling. Well, if you were to look at a commercial reverse osmosis machine, it has all the bells and whistles. It has the wash systems built into it. It has temperature control so that if things get too hot, they shut down. It has pressure controls so that they automatically shut down. And those are all wonderful to have. But the backyarder doesn't necessarily need all of those things. And we'll explain as we look at some different sizes of ROs just how simple it actually is for someone to put together their own reverse osmosis machine. Reverse osmosis has sort of traditionally been for the largest maple producers. And our goal is to change that. Our goal is to make it available to everyone from the huge maple producer right down to someone who may even only have 5 or 6 taps, just because it makes maple syrup so much more fun and energy efficient.